Hey guys, this is Gemini here, bringing you another comic book review. We are going to go over an Antarctic Press original by Ben Dunn called Warrior Nun Areala. This one is issue 2. This comic features Lilith and her interaction with Sister Shannon, the Warrior Nun. The comic starts off in hell with the character Lilith receiving contact information from the higher-up demon named Orcus. And he tells that there's a plot to release Lucifer from his prison. According to this comic, not every devil and demon and spirit gets along. Orcus is saying that Lucifer is a sworn enemy of his. And so they want to stop any fighting to make sure that Lucifer does not break out of his prison, because if he does, he wants all-out war with heaven and hell that might end all existence as we know it. Lilith, of course, is very loyal to her overlord, so she asks him what to do. He orders her to go to the earthly plane and seek out this human named Sulvius Julius, the same guy that did a sacrifice to the Dark Lord in the first issue. Of course, Lilith was commanding her underlings to get ready the portal, and she was portalized from this spiritual hell dimension to the earthly plane. The story goes back to the church where Sister Shannon Shotgun Mary and Father Terrence is watching over the boy that Mary saved last issue. The boy was not getting better, so Mary believed that she needed to do surgery to see what was going on. While the surgery was going on, there was an odd rash of murders of priests and nuns all over the New York area. The news suggested for every clergyman of the Catholic Church in New York to take shelter, and police will be there to watch over them. Mary ended up finding this digital chip inside the boy. Shannon was worried, but then Mary told Shannon to keep on praying and laying hands on him, because your healing touch is the only thing keeping him from bleeding out. So Father Terrence noticed that there was a big alarm going on, and he went to go check it out. Father Terrence went into this secret high electronic room where it seemed like the Pope or a high priest in the Catholic Church told him that according to their computer, Gabriel, the demonic activity rose at least 100 times more than normal in the last 24 hours. And he gave opportunity for Shannon to use this mecha suit called the Armor of God. Priest Terrence was worried and wondered if Shannon was really ready and worthy to use the armor. So the story goes back to the arms dealer Sylvius, who is setting up some kind of weird thing. I think it has to do with him unlocking Lucifer out of his cage. His henchman says that the boy that they lost actually had a certain chip that allowed them to go to the internet. Now remember, you guys, this was done in 95, right when the internet was just starting. So what we take for granted, it's what they trip out on. So Servius gets a phone call from this guy named Bloodshed Demon Foster. I think he's supposed to be some kind of wizard or demonologist guy because he ends up controlling this one badass of a demon. And it seems like he was done the task of to go get the boy from Shotgun Mary. The story goes to the church where Father Terrence and Shotgun Mary is looking over the hard drives that she got at the same time when she saved the boy. Sister Shannon felt like a third wheel, so she decided to go check up on the boy. But then all of a sudden, there is Bloodshed and Demon Foster, and they are about to grab the boy. But then, of course, Shannon's like, oh, heavens no, and she does a literal Hail Mary attack. And then she goes, bam, kick, hiya, whatcha, shabba, ah, smash, ching. Yeah, that's all the sound effects. Just as the boy was about to be kidnapped and taken back to the arms dealer guy, Lilith came to stop Bloodshed. Or is he Demon Foster? I don't quite know. I have to figure that out. Maybe if I read on more, I'll figure out who's who. And in classic literary jokes, Lilith says, let go of the boy. And of course, they're right over the edge of a building. And the guy said, sure, why not? And he literally lets go of the boy. So the boy goes free falling to the floor. But then, of course, Lilith grew out her wings and flew to catch the boy. Bloodshed, or Demon Foster, was trying to pretty much say, ooh, you can't get past me. And then Lilith is like, oh, really? Guess what? Never piss off a lady. She's like, shink, 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 shink. Then, of course, we have to know what Shannon's doing, Sister Shannon. She does this really interesting Sailor Moon-like attack called Holy Rosary Attack, which pretty much she throws out these rosary beads that become explosive. And the demon's like, ah, boom, bah, ah, yeah. And then, of course, I love this. She does a virgin kick. Love it. And also the reason why I like that virgin kick is because it actually finished off the demon. So Shannon was about to go check on the boy, which then she sees Lilith. And she's like, oh no. So she slices Lilith's wings off. And Lilith's like, hey, I'm here to help you. Lilith was trying to keep her composure and pretty much saying, WTF, Shannon, why'd you do that? And Shannon said, you're a demon. But then Lilith warned Shannon of an attack right behind her. So is really Lilith a demon, or is she somebody who plays by her own rules? And is she a help to Shannon or a threat? So pretty much this story was really good. It really made us question, who is Lilith and why is she so willing to help, even though she is working for a demon lord? Of course, the comic art is very revealing, especially for Lilith. But I think ultimately, the artwork is very good, very much action-packed, and very dynamic poses, I might say. So there you guys go. That is my review of Warrior Nun Areala number 2. Hope you guys like it. Please give it a thumbs up. Please give it a comment. Let me know what you think of these videos. Let me know if I should continue it or not. I'm getting enough views, but I'm not getting a lot of feedback. Also, make sure you check out The Warrior Nun on Netflix, which is now streaming. That show was amazeballs. It totally had the right feel for drama and historical context and mythology. Oh, I love the mythology. And the twist at the end, no spoilers, let's just say it's a crazy twist. Definitely go check it out. And I know these days are hard, everyone, but we all can be there for each other. Keep the faith and many blessings.